It's evident the US government and the general public are at odds when it comes to UFOs. Clearly one side feels they could be potential threats from foreign adversaries, while the other side is excited that we may learn about another intelligent civilization. Both are actually pretty interesting when you think about it, although one is definitely more of an immediate threat. And with all the recent talks of UFO sightings, the report that will be presented to Congress at the end of June, and of course the rising tensions between the US and other countries, well, some are concerned about what the UFOs could be used for. Today on Life's Biggest Questions, we're asking, what if the Pentagon UFOs are preparing for war? Smash that like button and let's get right into this video before we go to war with an alien civilization. So as we know, the UFOs, which have been the talk of the internet for quite some time now, are still a big old mystery. Although top officials who have remained anonymous but allegedly have insider information in regards to the report that is being submitted to Congress, well, there is no proof in it that aliens exist. However, there also isn't any proof denying their existence. Naturally, this has us more or less in the same position as before, where one side argues to prove something as fact, you need hard evidence. However, on the flip side, you could argue that without any evidence proving that other intelligent civilizations don't exist, how can you really be sure if you can't prove that they don't? Well, as I say, to each their own. Yet with that being said, it seems one common belief among both those who believe the UFOs are aliens and those who know they aren't can agree on one thing. The Pentagon taking these sightings seriously and not brushing them off as just theories is a win for us all. And if these UFOs were preparing for war, whether they were to be from another country or a civilization quite literally out of this world, well, that would be of utmost importance. As you could imagine, depending who is determined responsible for these pieces of tech drastically changes our question. And we'll look at both sides, but let's start with the less likely, more fun option. It is aliens. Now, if the UFOs, which the Pentagon prefers to call them unidentified aerial phenomena, or UAPs, were aliens preparing for war, well, you best believe the world better put aside their differences sooner than later. Otherwise, we're done for. We don't know what capabilities and technology an alien civilization would be able to come up with, or potentially use against us. However, it may not necessarily be as detrimental as many of us tend to believe. Why there is this notion that an alien civilization is more advanced, smarter, faster, and overall just better than us appears to come from a lack of confidence in the human race. If you really think about it, the idea of aliens being hostile and having laser guns or spaceships that are way beyond our understanding comes from popular media and stories told over generations. As we know, at least publicly as a society, we've all come to terms that we've yet to connect with aliens. So then where did any of our ideas regarding aliens come from? How do we know they're tall and green or have big black eyes? How do we know they aren't the size of a snail? You guys do realize it is possible aliens are literally the size of like our fingernails, and they're just a thriving society living in a much smaller world. Literally. The way we see giants, as well, giants, they'd see us in a similar way. And if that were the case, a war against the little guys wouldn't be so bad, but again, we can't underestimate anything's capabilities just because of its size. Rattlesnakes aren't that big, and they can kill most humans in just a few minutes or hours. Scary stuff. But we also need to consider another angle. It is possible the aliens are taller than us. Maybe they're bigger, and maybe they do have technology that we've yet to use or discover. But again, that doesn't necessarily mean it would be detrimental to us. Now, as often expected of aliens, they have laser guns. Could it be due to the fact that we as a society know that lasers and humans don't mesh well? Probably. So naturally, in media and fiction, TV shows, films, comics, video games, whatever it may be, we've made aliens appear to be hostile and the greater species. But what if their tech isn't all that advanced? What if we're a more advanced society? There have been plenty of rumors and theories that the US government has seized alien spacecrafts or UFOs that have crashed in hopes of reverse engineering, understanding a new type of technology by taking it apart, only to put it back together. But what if the same could be said for alien civilizations? What if, hypothetically speaking of course, whenever we send astronauts out to space, aliens are picking up any debris or even tech that never returns home in order to reverse engineer what we've made? What I'm saying is, take what most people think, which is aliens come to Earth, the government hides everything and studies their findings, and just flip it. Humans explore space, send probes and satellites out to space, and aliens find them, try to understand and reverse engineer it all. And with that in mind, going back to the original question, let's say aliens were preparing for war and they did attack, but their weapons were just weakened versions of our technology that we've already perfected. Whether it be guns, missiles, bombs, who knows? But in a sense, it would almost be like the aliens bringing a knife to a gunfight. as we'd simply just have much better versions of anything and everything they have. Now, this is all under the assumption that we were wrong, and that the aliens are actually trying to grow as a society and thrive by copying us. As we know, the majority of those who believe in aliens tend to think they're the smarter ones. And if they're the more intelligent civilization and are capable of using tech that we can't even imagine, well, obviously their UFOs preparing for war is a bad thing. It likely wouldn't even be much of a war, given that they could potentially be using spacecrafts that we can't even target. How can you stop a potential threat or attack if you can't even target the threat or attacker in the first place? It's really scary when you think of it. And that leads us to the flip side. This is the work of potential adversaries. Foreign governments who are either potentially spying or simply showing the world they're much more technologically advanced than the rest of the world. Two countries which have been making the rounds, at least in American media, would be Russia and China. Obviously, it's no secret that Russia and China are seen as the two biggest security threats to America. Between the nuclear capabilities, the race to have the best tech for their military, as well as the space race, these three countries appear to do all they can to be seen as the number one powerhouse country in the world. The one with the best tech, strongest military, and anything else that would be seen as a massive accomplishment internationally. But as you can imagine, if it was determined that either one of these countries, or any country for that matter, were spying on the US, well, as I like to say, the poop would hit the fan. I can't say the S word because apparently YouTube is more strict than middle school nowadays, so sorry guys. But as you can imagine, if any country was caught spying on the US, they wouldn't take too kindly to it. Nor should they. I think it's safe to say if any country were caught spying on another country, some form of retaliation would be expected. Maybe cooler heads would prevail, but an emergency UN meeting would likely be in order to prevent two countries from going at it. Using the example of the US and China or Russia, if it was determined they were spying, either one of them, I'm not sure the US would necessarily attack, but they would definitely try to punish either country. Introducing sanctions to make it tougher for imports or exports, refusing to cooperate on certain international deals, in general, the strain on the relationships between the said countries would intensify until, well, until it would reach a boiling point of no return. Boom. You guys get what I'm saying? Hopefully you guys get what I'm saying. So hopefully, let's just say it's aliens who are actually relying on us to advance their civilization, not the other way around. That way, if they're trying to attack us, we could be like, bro, we invented the airplane. You think you could kill us with that thing? We have fighter jets. You got like a Boeing 737. Fighter jet versus Boeing 737, fighter jet wins every time. Now, as always, guys, I'd love to hear your thoughts on this one down below. For now, let's do some comment replies from the video. Top 10 UFO sightings confirmed to be real. Mitriano said, even if they land, it will be interesting for a week, then everyone will go on about their lives. That I strongly disagree with. That I 100% disagree with. I think for a while, people are gonna be talking about it. The fact that for so long, the world and governments have downplayed this idea of UFOs and aliens, and now they're admitting to it, I think this is just the tip of the iceberg. We're just getting started. Universe Mike 1986 said, I just asked my roommate yesterday why it doesn't seem like a big deal. Like, our government, US, basically called people crazy for decades, and now they're admitting it's happening, and yet I barely hear about it. It is so crazy. That's the point I'm trying to make. For so long, you said, oh, aliens are real. People were like, this guy's crazy. This guy, put him in an asylum. You gotta lock it. Like, it was this, saying aliens and UFOs are real is like saying the sky is green. Everyone looked at you like you had two heads. Everyone thought you were crazy. Everyone thought, you know, you were on drugs or something. Like, it was, you were like the joker of the town. No one took you seriously. And now the whole script has been flipped. Everyone's like, oh, UFOs are definitely real. And you're right. It should be a way bigger deal than it is. This just goes to show you that as a society, we literally only buy into what the media shows us. The Kardashians, Kim Kardashian or Kanye has a new girlfriend, that's been making more headlines than this news right here. What does that tell you? Darren D'Souza said, now they will blame the COVID on aliens, LMAO. Look, I don't wanna get too into this, but I'll tell you guys right now, if anybody tries to say that this thing started from aliens, game over. All right, guys, that's all for this one. I've been your host, Pepper, and we'll see you guys in the next video, as long as aliens don't destroy civilization, which, no promises, but I don't think so.